Anyway, oh yikes, I'm bummed out tonight. I guess I've been singing a lot lately, and it was the deal. Getting clarity. So clarity is good, but then on the same token, there's like a few that just run away with me. So a few notes that are grumbling me out. I mean, I know I have this vast assortment of arias, you know, like 70 or something, that I can, you know, grab at, but, you know, there'll be one song that I want to get through, and then it has its moment that, you know, grumbles you back into its, gosh dang it, you know, and the other singer, because I'm listening to the other singer, you know, sing it. I'm like, well, can't I just break out and make my own, you know, and not be a mimicker so much, or, you know, that's the deal, you know, it's always the problem when you're hearing somebody else's voice, is that you don't want to be the mimicker. And then, no, you can't really be the mimicker, but at the same token, it's like, oh my gosh, what am I gonna do if I can't get that note? You know, I get the whole entire song. Everything. You know. And it's just like evades me, you know, it just runs away. It's always these little tight little dinko pianissimos. Little tinies. Now, there's training. There is the training where you take the voice, and it's more of that yell technique. You open up your voice to the high. I'm actually against it. I'm against it. I know that was Caballé was training that for a time, but I'm against it. I think it's a voice shredder. I don't think it's a good calm. I don't think it's a... It has... you know, maybe some of these women or these girls, they need it. You know, maybe they need, you know, that la, you know, to get out there really quick, you know, because they don't have it. They need the gusto. But no, I think it damages the chords. You know, to have, you know, it's just like, you know, so this is where I'm at. I'm fighting this moment, you know, just have the tiny channel to the whatever it is, high, or, you know, because as soon as it's the loud push, there is the chance of, you just made a loud, pushy voice. What did I want a loud, pushy voice for? You know, to get to the high note is never supposed to be this loud, pushy all the time. It's supposed to have, you know, that quaint quiet. So yeah, so I'm in this defunct motion. And then I'm of that, you know. And then running through, you know, exactly which songs. You know, can I get through that I'm not fumbled, you know, by this note, by a particular note. And so then I'm like, oh my gosh, I'm just wrecked. I'm wrecked by the French language. I'm wrecked by the French people. I'm just wrecked. You know? That, you know, simple things, I'm just like in that, I'm like, okay, fine, maybe I am mentally retarded when it comes to learning languages. Maybe I just am. That's just life. So then just that simple thing, you know, it's so easy to, like, I run with something, like, in my head and memory, I have française versus français, and I'm like, oh no, I've said that, like, a lot recently, and it's all incorrect, You know, more often it's français, with not a says. Française is with the, when you have the son attached. Française son. So yeah, it gets all this like ah, and I'm like, well, I'm not the teacher really, but I have a very good pronunciation, and I know I can read like these Wikipedia furs or whatever, and I can even do that for like a living. You know, if somebody wants to traduire, you know, I can translate, because I have a feeling there are so few people here in America that even speak French that it's frightening. And so then when I go on, that I'm probably one of the only ones that even have a like a distant quality of understanding the accents. That's even more frightening, you know. And then I'm looking back at French tourism, I'm like, what's gonna happen? It's almost like, you know, the French, they do their best to be tight, I will say, tight regimentists of language, tight, you know, they're real tight about it, uptight. And so because they're so uptight, it just angers people, and they don't want to go back. It's like, okay, fine, I've been to France, I don't ever want to go again. You know? Even if they have children, they're going to be like, well, I don't know, I'll send you to Brazil. Why have them go there and just have that feeling of a slap in the face? Why would I do that? You know, as a parent. Parents wouldn't do that. There are so many other places to go. So in consequence, the French being so uptight and so like I don't know, pedantic about diction, pedantic about the language exact, and the vite, everything so fast on purpose, you know. I'm well, you lost tourists, you know. You lose not tourists just one generation, you lose tourists the next. And I know they're populating and they're bringing and they're populating and they're bringing and they're populating and they're bringing. But there's only so long, you know, France can keep claiming their biggest industry is tourism. There's only so long. There are other places to go. And even, like, Morocco is becoming safe now. You know what I mean? There are better places to go. Like on holiday? I mean, if it's just to go there, it's just to go there to see Notre Dame. If it's just to go there to, like, well, okay, all right, go see the Côte d'Azur or whatever, maybe. No, they're not naked there. There's no reason to go there. That, like, fascinata reason for the weirdo in Milwaukee, he doesn't even need to go there anymore for that. So yeah, France doesn't offer anything strange or bizarre. I just think they've lost a lot of people. You know, and it's kept up in the news, it's kept up in how the people are. I know it's the way it is that it's all about keeping France, and this whole EU smashing, you know, you're feeling like, you know, crunched in there to this little tiny, you know, it's getting smashed in by all these others, you know, they're trying to move in all the time. So it has to do with that, obviously. You know, you're keeping your own border, you know, with the language. Border keeps your you know, the French language is keeping your border. You know, you don't need the douane, you don't need that. You already have the language, and you already have the people. What are they doing? They're giving the patrol, you know, to the tourists. You know, and we feel flogged, you know, just flogged. So anyway, I don't know. I mean, just, I guess you can, I mean, my advice to France is maybe change change the group you advertise to, maybe advertise to China more, you know, get the tourists from other places. Because I think you have run out. I think you've run out of Americans. There's all these things going on with you know, the danger, you know, the danger to travel also. Yeah. You know, go somewhere else, you know. Maybe the parents will send their kids to Quebec. You know, maybe that's more interesting. Safer. You know, all of these horribles in the news. So I don't know. I wanted it to be. I never wanted France to be like this, like Euro Disney with the. Because I was there and it was just awful. I didn't like the French looking at me like that with this funny smile, the commercial smile. I didn't like that. I thought that was awful. You know, that's not needed. That wasn't necessary. I don't know. Yeah, I don't know. It's just like I said, you know, all that time I was there. I guess I would maybe bring that to the Maries of the villages, you know, if people are living there and they are from other places on the planet, and they are like me. I mean, I could have joined a class, but it would have needed to be a real basic class, and then I don't even think they had basic classes. You know, a lot of these places out there, I mean, you're just out in the middle of nowhere. You know, with the occasional hunters. So there's not really like even the ability to travel to a class. So I don't know. Yeah, so we're stuck here on the internet, and then I'm not ever finding anything except just the pushy. Just the pushy, hurry up and just know it already group. And so I don't know. Anyway, so I was cheated. I've just been cheated. I've been cheated. And anyhoot. So, well. Yeah, anywho. Yeah, what was the competition about again? The competition against, you know, because people do start to take it personally. They're like, it's the competition against me, you know. You know, it's the competition of your obvious power and your linguist skills. You know, is the competition just against me? You know, so you can run around and behind. I just learned a word today, watch out. Sottise, which means stupid, idiot. So you can go behind my back and say sottise. Does that excite you? Anyway, yeah, we talk about, you know, where are people's compassions and where are their, just, I guess it's all associated, isn't it? Every drop of your blood is associated with money. Just as a wife, you know, gee whiz, I just didn't shell it out, did I? So, what was the deal? It was something. It was something else. Oh yeah, there was a word. It was about that. It was sush. I said it the other day, and it was incorrect. And it's an interesting word because you can souche, which means to shovel, which means how much crap I've absolutely dealt with from the French people on a daily, if ever I had to go to the store or whatever. How much just rude. Okay, so that's souche. But then there is souche. Now, souche, like a bouche. Souche is le français souche. De la français souche. Okay, so of the French ancestry, of the French blood. Of the French bloodlines. It's something I should have learned already, but yeah, so that's one. Now, would you say Française souche, or would you just say Français souche without the says? I don't know. I don't know, you know. Maybe if I had $1 million in front of me, somebody would tell me. Sometimes I believe it is something such as they're still out there with these ginger hate crimes just right in my face. You know, are the French typically just kinder to people who do not have red hair? So yeah, so anyway. So it's a tough monarchy group, isn't it? When I'm looking at William, I'm looking at a tough monarchy group. I just don't think the red hairs are the red haired group are loved and adored. You know, there's still so much weird token like backwater in their brains, you know, that I'm a witch also. You know, obviously I have spells, I have enchantments that I can create or destroy. You know, take time near me and I can interrupt your life and ruin it, the rest of it. You know? So there's all of this. All of this. Watch out, the red-haired woman. So, anywho, yeah, I just didn't really learn French, did I? So, anyway, it is that, yeah, of the French heritage is de la Française souche. Yeah, I really gotta cut that Francais. If you're saying le Francais ont, the French have, you have to cut it. If you say the French are, les Français sont, the French are. You see the difference? So with the S-O-N-T or the O-N-T. Gosh dang it. So anywho, I'm done, I'm done. So between the arias, I am just not in a good mood.